Hello, my beautiful Libby loves. This is Dr. V. Welcome to a new pick a card reading where we are going to be going in deep into the energies of what is going on right now between you and your twin flame, your soulmate, your crush, your beloved. Really, the labels don't matter. All that matters is how you feel in your heart, the journey that you're on, and what kind of outcome are you looking for, not only to have union or reunion with that special person, but also to lead your best life. So if you are new to this channel, welcome. I'm so happy to have you here. Make sure that you do hit that subscribe button and join this incredible Live Tarot community where we are all here to support each other, love and uplift one another. Now, for those of you who've been with me for quite a while, you know that I was in Orlando last week. So now I am back home. I am back to my normal readings, but I do want to thank all of you who joined me on the live streams that I did from Orlando. Those were so much fun. And I really do appreciate all of your amazing comments, your love, your support. You guys were just awesome. Thank you. That was a lot of fun. And, you know, as I travel more, I hope to do more of those in the future. So, for today, let's get right into revealing your person's true feelings for you and this connection right now. So I have three piles here for you. You can choose number one, number two, number three, or you can choose all of them and take the messages that resonate for you and leave the rest. So please do be gentle with yourself because this is a general reading. Not everything may resonate for your situation. If you'd like to have specific guidance on what's going on in your unique journey, you can have a private reading with me, and the link to that is in the box below, as well as the link to all of these oracle decks that I have created for all of you who are on this journey to love and abundance. So let's get into your group choices. So for group number one, we have compassion. As you pray each day for greater compassion, a new self is born, drawing new people and experiences. Dear Lord, help me feel ever-deepening self-acceptance. May I see myself as you see me. Well, that's a really beautiful message. So why don't you take a moment to see which one of these you feel most intuitively guided to. So if you'd like to close your eyes, take a deep breath. Really feel your way to this change. Don't scare yourself with the next 40 steps. All you need is that one next action. You can say to love, just show me the first step and change me into one who can take it. I love that. Beautiful. All right. And for our beautiful group number three, we have contentment. You can learn to rest in what you already have and already are. Suddenly you remember, I'm right here resting in God. All right, so go ahead and make your selection. We're gonna get started with group number one right here. All right, our beautiful group one who chose compassion. Let's take a look at revealing what your person is feeling about you and this connection today. We're gonna start with your tarot. So let's see what we have here. Eight of Cups, interesting. Queen of Pentacles. And the Nine of Wands. All right, very interesting energies coming through here. So I am feeling for many of you, there has been a definite struggle or separation that is coming through here. And you know, it's interesting because I do feel that some of the issues that have gone on here, some of the things that may have been blocking this connection or becoming a particular kind of life situation that is putting pressure on this connection, I feel it really does have to do with a lot of the material aspects of what is going on here, as well as a combination of how those material aspects are being dealt with. And so I'm feeling from your person that they have a lot of kind of baggage, okay? They have a lot of baggage that they need to deal with. And this baggage, to me, is very much about how real life situations in their life, like very materially oriented situations in their life, have kind of really made them who they are today. And so they're dealing with two fronts here. It's kind of like battling on two fronts. One is the aspect of their own mind, you know, the way that they are complicating certain things in their life that maybe need to be simplified. And I feel like your person does tend to do that. They tend to not be able to find the more simple path towards resolution. So they may be somebody who tends to struggle with trying to get clarity on situations. And that, I feel like, has been their greatest weakness in life, because I do feel that your person tends to emotionally struggle with things more than they really need to. As in, there are often solutions in front of them that can be more simple in their life, but they choose to sometimes overlook the more simple solutions, and then they get themselves kind of wrapped up in, you know, more complicated paths to getting to where they want to be. So I am sensing, I am feeling that that has definitely been a form of frustration for you, beautiful one who is watching this, because I do feel that your energy is very much coming through as this Queen of Pentacles. And I also feel that this is one of the things that your person admires about you. Like, I feel like you are coming through here with this energy as something that your person also aspires to be, as in they see you as somebody who is very grounded, who is very practical, and they see you as somebody they want to spend the rest of their life with. Like, you are marriage material. You are all that brings stability, consciousness, and intentionality to their world, right? And again, I feel like your person tends to be triggered very easily when things go wrong, and they tend to put up their walls very quickly. They tend to become very defensive. And again, I feel like that's because they have struggled for a very long time in finding the kind of grounding in their life that you already have achieved. And this is why you may compliment them in a really good way, right? Like, you may bring the spirit of stability, intentionality, and consciousness to this person, because I don't feel that your person is very good right now at doing things in a more intentional way. And I feel like you are very good at that. Like, you have come to some kind of level in your life that has been very hard won. Like, I don't feel that you were also naturally like this, but I feel like you have worked on yourself. You have put in a lot of the, you know, spiritual work, the awareness work, like the work of, okay, how can I be more intentional in my life? How can I create the life, the love, everything I want through intentionality, through being much more grounded and clear on what it is that I want, where am I going, and how do I really want to achieve those things? And again, I feel like there is a bit of a disconnect here, in the sense that you seem to be much more aware of these things. You have worked on these things, where your person tends to sometimes give up on things easily. Like, when things get tough, they tend to walk away a lot easier, because I don't feel that they have those skills, right? They don't have the skills of, okay, how can I take a problem, an obstacle, or a situation in my life, and instead of turning my back towards it, because sometimes with Eight of Cups, it's like, sometimes there are things that you do need to let go of, release, and turn your back on in your life, right? But sometimes I feel like kind of like the drawback of the Eight of Cups is that some people tend to do that too easily. They tend to want to turn their backs when things get tough, instead of being able to understand that certain things are worth fighting for, right? That certain things, they may not be the easiest path, they may not be the easiest road, but if you work on it, the rewards can greatly outweigh the challenges. And this is one of the things that your person with this Nine of Wands tends to be resistant to. So this is why I'm feeling that this is one of their great spiritual lessons that they are going through right now. And I do feel that they are very much inspired by your energy of this Queen of Pentacles, of not giving up, right? Like, you are much more intentional in picking the right battles and being able to assess where something is worth fighting for versus where something is worth walking away from. And so I feel like your person, like I said, is a few steps behind you on this. They are still trying to figure that out. And that is why you may be getting the sense of woundedness from them right now. They tend to be Nine of Wands, especially if some of you are in some form of separation or you've had some sort of conflict. I'm feeling for some of you, there's definitely been a conflict here. There may have been a fight, a disagreement, a blow up. People have been hurt. There may have been words spoken here for some of you. So your person right now, it's like they know that you and this connection are worth fighting for. They're very inspired by who you are, but they may also be a bit in their ego right now. They may be standoffish. They may be feeling wounded. They may be feeling like they want to walk away, even though I feel like deep within them, their true spirit, their soul is telling them, don't walk away. Their soul is telling them, you know, bring down these walls that you have built up around yourself. It's not just always about you and how wounded you feel, right? There are certain things that are worth working through and that you need to build some sort of clarity and consciousness if you want to hold on to this connection, because deep down inside they know, I mean, they see you as this Queen of Pentacles energy. So they know that you are the real deal. Okay, you are worth fighting for. This connection is worth fighting for. This is not one of those connections that are easy to walk away from, but I do feel that your person has kind of become used to walking away, right? And so this is an energy that if they are feeling with this Nine of Wands that they need to walk away, this is something that they're going to have to actively kind of consciously resist that temptation, right? If they want to truly be with you, they're going to have to tell themselves, no, this is not the kind of situation that I wish to walk away from. This is not one of those times. See? Yeah. Yep. Yeah. So yeah, this is a confirmation, exactly a confirmation of what we've already been seeing. So see, your person right now, in terms of their true feelings for you, they're definitely going through a lot of anxiety. Look at this. See? They are feeling very anxious right now because they're trying to resist that urge to turn their back and walk away. Because remember, with this Eight of Cups, I feel like your person is definitely very easily triggered when it comes to their emotions. They're not yet the most mature. You know, they don't have the most mature energy yet when it comes to their emotions. They do tend to be anxious. They do tend to get wrapped up in their own kind of sense of resistance to more difficult or trying emotional states. And that's another reason why I feel like with this Nine of Wands, this anxiety is actually very, very usual. You know, like, it's not surprising at all. I feel that people who are very much susceptible to the Nine of Wands energy are definitely anxious, right? They're on guard. They're always waiting for the next thing to go wrong. You know, they kind of tend to be a bit on the pessimistic side. Like, they struggle with optimism. Their anxiety also makes it difficult for them to believe that it is possible to change this outlook, right? They've kind of gotten used to and comfortable with those states of being. So it's going to take them a while to get out of it. See, round and round. So your person is definitely used to this. This is a repetitive energy for them. So I feel that there's definitely a desire that your person has to get out of this. I do feel that they are tired of going round and round in these circles. I feel like their life has definitely been very repetitive, as in, you know, things happen, you know, things go wrong, whether it's in their past relationships or in, you know, material aspects of their life. And I feel like every time things go wrong, it's like they decide or they choose to walk away rather than stay and work it out. And that's not just in relationships. I feel like they've walked away from jobs, from different situations in life that weren't serving them, instead of kind of staying and working it through. So I do feel that there's a bit of a running away, not wanting to deal with complicated emotional situations coming through with your person. So definitely they're wanting some sort of a new beginning and some sort of a spiritual development here. So this is what I find very hopeful here. This is the good aspect of what is going on here, because you, as you can see, your person is definitely tired of the repetition. Okay, they're definitely tired of the repetitiveness of the ways in which they have been triggered by various things in their life, and the way in which that they have dealt with those things through anxiety, through this Nine of Wands energy, has really not served them at all. So in terms of their feelings for you, they definitely want a new beginning. Isn't this beautiful? Right? New beginnings. They're also looking for enlightenment, pursue spiritual growth. See? So they're getting to a point, and this is important because I do think they needed to get to this point. They're getting to a point where it is time to do things differently. It is time to approach things in a new way. A dawn is coming for your person, right? They kind of have been struggling in darkness for quite a while here, but I am feeling that there's something about this connection with you, this love that they have for you, that is inspiring them to have this new beginning, right? I feel like I'm almost feeling like you have been a catalyst in this for them. It's almost like if they had not met you, if they had not fallen in love with you, they may have kind of just kept going on round and round in this energy, right? They may not have really been inspired to make the changes that are necessary here in order to have a really positive, long-term, committed relationship with you. So this may have been what they needed. You know, this Queen of Pentacles energy may have been exactly what they needed to find that new beginning, to find the inspiration to commit to something that is greater than themselves and that is greater and better than the life that they have already experienced before meeting you. So I feel that coming through very clearly here. So let's get some specific messages. These are going to be specific, so just take them as they resonate. My world is falling apart right now and I don't know how to fix it. It's not right for me to dump that on you. Yeah, definitely with the Nine of Wands, Eight of Cups. So there's definitely something going on. Remember how I said that there's either something that is emotional and material. And right now, I feel like with that Eight of Cups and that Nine of Wands, your person is kind of feeling the pressure of both of those things at the same time. I'm totally heartbroken that we are not together right now. I'm up at night worrying about us and our future. Yeah, so remember I said there's definitely been for many of you some sort of struggle or separation here. No matter what ups and downs we have, it's always been you. You are my one true love. See? Told you. With this Queen of Pentacles energy, I'm telling you, you are definitely the catalyst for change here. I'm feeling that very, very deeply. You are the catalyst. Their love for you is serving as a major catalyst for your person to start evolving, expanding, going to the next level of who they are in love as well as in life. And that's a really wonderful thing. So let's take a look at outcome. Where does this person want to go next? Oh, wow. Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, so see, I'm telling you, this entire reading, it has come through so strongly that your person is definitely influenced right now by forces that are very material world oriented, as well as emotional and romance oriented. And that is why I feel that they are a bit in a state of overwhelm, right? They're needing to work this out. And we're also getting a very strong masculine energy coming through here. So if you are a feminine watching for your masculine, I do feel that there is a lot of masculine energy, the energy of your masculine towards you as his Queen of Pentacles. And I say his and her just to simplify. These are energies. They are not bound by gender roles, just to be clear here. But there's definitely a lot of, you know, energy here about wanting to be the masculine that is worthy of this feminine, right? That them seeing you as this Queen of Pentacles, they know that you have achieved a certain type of mastery in your emotional and material world that they are also aspiring to have. So they know that they need to level up, okay? Big goals, both emotional and material. Level up to being where you are, because what they truly seek is this beautiful union. Isn't that amazing? Look at this. Reconciliation, union, reunion, eternal love, your time has come. Oh my gosh, it's just so beautiful. Wow. Amazing. I love it. So let me know in the comment box below what you thought of your reading. If you'd like to have a personal reading with me or order any of the oracle decks that I have created for you, all of the links are in the box below. I love you so much, guys. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll see you all on the next video. All right, my beautiful group two who chose change. We're going to take a look at your person's true feelings for you in this connection at this time. So we're gonna start with your tarot. Let's take a look. The Hanged Man. The Six of Cups, beautiful. Oh, and the Four of Pentacles, fascinating, guys. Whoa, this is some really, I'm feeling this very sudden rush of very powerful energy coming through here. I feel like there's an energy that is so strong coming from your person towards you. And I feel like it's this strong pulling desire to come out of the shadows. Because there's something here about your person. There's a shadowy energy, okay? There's an energy of somebody hiding, something that which is hidden. Somebody who is used to hiding their true self. And I feel that they may have been hiding that true self from you, but I don't think it's just that. I feel like this is just who they are. There's something about this particular person, this particular energy that is very introverted. Okay, they're very introverted. This is not an extroverted energy. This is somebody who tends to be extremely conscious and careful about where they direct their energy flow. Okay, so this is why I feel that for some of you, you may have felt, as you are getting to know this person, you may have felt that it's almost like pulling teeth, like getting them to open up, getting them to share of themselves. I do feel a very secretive energy from this person. They have a very hard time revealing their true self. And I do feel that for many of them, there is a particular persona that they present to the world. And I'm not saying that they're duplicitous. I'm not getting the energy of duplicity or deception for the wrong reasons, or like, you know, trying to be like, it's not like con artist or, you know, trying to take advantage of people by being duplicitous. I just feel that because they are so introverted, and because they have certain fears, and they've kind of gotten used to kind of hiding behind a particular persona or particular face that they show to the world, they become very comfortable with that. Okay, so this is why it's like they are very much a different person publicly, and they may have a very different side to them privately. And I feel like one of the things that they are feeling right now is that they feel that you are their soulmate, okay? But that's the problem, all right? Like, I feel like the fact that they have realized that you are their person with the Six of Cups energy, it's like the fact that they feel that you are like a wish fulfilled, like a dream come true. You have everything that they have ever wanted in a partner, in love, right? Like the potential of what they see in you is so great that it makes them even more afraid to show you those parts of themselves that they keep very hidden. Okay, so it's almost like it's almost like counterintuitive. Like, you would think that when you meet your soulmate, the love of your life, and you recognize this person, whether it's your twin flame, whether it's your soulmate, really doesn't matter. But, you know, the fact that they have recognized you, the fact that they are aware of you, they are conscious of this spiritual connection, this really deep connection that the two of you have, has been a bit disconcerting to them. So instead of them being like super excited and like, oh my God, I've met my soulmate, this is like the best thing ever, I've met my person, I feel like your person struggles with that. They think instead like, oh no, I've met my soulmate. Like, you know, it's like kind of like that opposite. Oh no, what am I gonna do now? Like, how am I going to manage this? How am I going to open up to you, is what they're thinking. They know that they want to, but they have never done it before. I do feel with this Four of Pentacles energy, your person is very used to holding their cards close to the vest. This is somebody who's probably very good at playing poker. You know, I feel like they, again, they are very good at presenting a specific face to the world, and that face can look very, very appealing. Like, they can present themselves to the world as somebody who is extremely you know, calm, cool, collected, just like a cool person, somebody who's, you know, fascinating and intriguing. They do have an air of mystery. I think people fall for the air of mystery that they also carry around them, but they give a very self-assured energy out to the world, but it's not really that much in alignment with how they feel inside. Like, they've become very good at it. And again, I don't want to put them, I'm not saying this to put them down or criticize them in any way. I just feel that the persona that they give off to people who don't know them that well is their security blanket. It is the way that they can feel comfortable out in the world, right? And so they very much hold those cards very close to their vest. And I do feel very strongly that in past relationships that they've had with other people, this has sufficed. As in, this kind of the way they've been operating has not really gotten in their way. And I feel that the reason for that is because they have never truly felt the depths of real love. So, you know, relationships that they've had in the past, they may have been good, they may have been bad, but they were always to a certain level. They never pushed past a certain level of depth because this was their shield, right? This Four of Pentacles was the shield that your person always kept around them. And what I find very fascinating about this is I'm getting the energy that some of the people that they were with in the past didn't even notice, okay? This persona that they put forward is so good that people that they were with in the past didn't even question them. But I feel that you do. Like, I feel that you have seen something deeper in this person. I don't feel that they're able to fool you or to get past your senses on this. Like, I feel that you intuitively know that there's a lot more to this person than meets the eye. Okay, but many, many other people have not seen that in them, and therefore it did not scare them, right? Like, they were able to keep up that sense of self-assurance, that sense of self-confidence. But with you, they feel raw. With you, it's almost like when you look at them, and this is very specific. I'm sorry. I'm feeling very specific energies here. So like I say, just take what resonates, you know, if it resonates for you. If it doesn't, then it's not your story, and that's okay too. But I feel like this person, when you look at them, they feel raw, as in they feel that you are truly seeing them. Like your vision, your way of interacting with them, the way you speak to them, the way you look at them, it makes them feel naked. It makes them feel raw because they feel that they cannot play that same game with you. Okay, you can see through it because you are their counterpart. You are their divine counterpart. So obviously you're not going to be taken in by this kind of outward persona the way other people have been. And that is why your person right now, they are struggling in this hangman's energy, as in they are a bit scared. Okay, they're feeling very scared around this connection. So for some of you, this may be manifesting as they may have gone silent. They may be a bit like, they may be acting a bit uncertain. They may be acting scared. They may have pulled away. That's for some of you. For others of you, that's not the case. You're together, but there's still something. You're feeling some sort of a block because look at them. They're suspended right now. They've kind of gone into this suspension energy of them wanting to kind of figure out the truth here for themselves. You know, like they know that they can't be in this hanged man suspended form, you know, for long, as in at some point they're gonna have to decide whether to let this go because it's too uncomfortable, or to give in to this love fully and bring down all the walls of this Four of Pentacles, right? To bring down all the barriers between the two of you, and then to really bring down that persona and show you who they really, really are. And that's why this hanged man is a really big spiritual lesson for your person. Yeah, see? Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Wow. Wow, look at this. Didn't I say that there's a duplicity to this person? Oh my gosh. Thank you, Spirit. What an incredible confirmation here. Deceit. So I feel, again, like I don't want you to get scared with this card because I'm not feeling that your person is harmful. I'm not feeling that they're some sort of like a liar, cheater, deceiver. I don't feel that's what it is. I feel like this deceit is more about them. It's more about the way they have become accustomed to operating in their life, right? With that Four of Pentacles. Didn't I say this before? They hide behind a certain mask. Okay, and that's where I feel that the deceit is more, I feel like it is hurting them more than it's hurting anybody else, because what this kind of deceit, self-deceit is doing is really blocking them from experiencing real, deep, profound, passionate love with you. And that is why I feel that they are definitely rethinking this, right? They're definitely rethinking it with this hangman's energy. Like they are like literally caught in this balance here, you know, trying to figure out, like, do I want to hold on to this mask that I've always worn? Or is it time for the mask to come down so that I can experience this real love? It is time for me to be flexible, because I do feel, again, that sense of, you know, always holding your cards close to the vest, always being careful, conscious, very guarded is a form of inflexibility, right? It's a form of being stuck. It's a form of being stuck in your ways and not being able to be flexible about yourself, not being able to open up and let somebody see who you really are. And so this is a really lovely thing, because I feel like they are wanting with you to bring those walls down and to start being flexible, to start opening up that energy, because it is definitely a blocked energy. But I do feel that they are afraid. One of the reasons why they're afraid of opening up from this energy is because there's something within them, okay? There's some volatility there within them. See, they're coming through with this volcano energy. So I feel like there's a lot of things that they're repressing, Okay, things that may be like inner child wounds, things that have been haunting them from their past or other experiences that they've had. I feel this Four of Pentacles is also very much in alignment with volatility, because oftentimes when you have this Four of Pentacles energy, you are repressing things, right? You're holding on to things very tightly. You may be keeping them deep within you, but you feel that if you let yourself come out of the Hanged Man's energy and you choose love, you choose illumination, you choose truth, your truth, you stand in your truth instead of hiding behind that mask of deceit, then I feel that they're afraid that if they are to do that, this volcano is going to erupt. Like everything they've been holding down and repressing within themselves is going to come out in an explosive way. And I feel like that's what they are afraid of. And that is why they keep a very tight lid, a tight hold on themselves. So they're definitely going through a process of seeking enlightenment. That's the other aspect of the Hanged Man that is really profound, is that the Hanged Man suspends himself in order to give himself a pause, in order to seek enlightenment, right? It's like that energy of, I need to illuminate. I need to find illumination. I need to see the truth of what, of where I am and where I want to be. And so this is beautiful. So your person is definitely going through a spiritual process, a spiritual evolution with this peacock's energy. Raise your standards. And again, I feel like Four of Pentacles, hate to come back to this, but I feel like this is a dominant thing that your person is definitely struggling to overcome at this time, because the thing with sticking to a Four of Pentacles energy is kind of sometimes sticking to lower standards, like not having higher standards for yourself, settling for less because you're too afraid to open up to the true gifts of the universe, right? So this is actually very powerful energy coming through here. Let's get some specific messages from your person. What would they say to you? What would they say to you? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. See, you're the one for me. We're twin souls, and that's what scares me the most. I'm seeing it all clearly now. See? See, that's why I'm telling you, they have realized that you are their person. And that is why it is such a struggle for them to finally bring that mask down, right? To finally reveal their true self. They've never felt this way about anybody else. So you are the first person to inspire them to do this. And that's a huge thing for them. You know, it's not going to be easy for them. We come from different worlds. Our perspectives can clash sometimes. Can we work this out? So yeah, definitely. Because I do feel the energy of you being much more open and receptive, right? To love, to this commitment, to this relationship than they have been probably up till now. I don't know if I can live up to your image of me. I'm afraid that I won't be good enough for you. See, again, I'm telling you, wow, spirit's on fire right now. Look at this. See, so they're afraid that if they drop this mask that they are so used to wearing in the world, they won't be good enough. That their true self, the true person that they are, is somehow not good enough for you, and maybe not good enough for the world either. So there's definitely some self-esteem issues here that your person is also working on, needs to work on. And I feel like their love for you is definitely a strong inspiration for them, right? Like this is kind of their moment. It's like, okay, well, it's now or never, okay? I've lived my life like this for quite a while now, but I haven't really felt the consequences of it. Why? Because I've never truly been in love. But now I am truly in love. And if I don't open up and if I don't drop all the BS and show my real self to you, I may lose you and I may lose true love, right? So now this is their moment. It's like they're going to have to step into this or they're going to have to step away, right? Interesting. So what's the outcome here? Where could this be going, spirit? Interesting. Yeah. See? So this is the thing. So didn't I say, oh my gosh, spirit, thank you again. I said, the time has come. The time is now. See? This is their moment. This is the make or break moment. Up till now, I feel in this connection, there has been a divine timing, as in it may have been slow. It may have been sluggish. It may have been frustrating for you, feeling like you're not getting anywhere, like this relationship is not moving forward, because Four of Pentacles also slow down, right? Slow moving energy. But look at this. Your person is realizing now that the time is now. It's going to be now or never, or else they may just lose you. So they are standing at a crossroads right now, and they're ready to make a decision. And they know that it's their beliefs that have really been getting in the way here. And it's time to clear that path. It's time to make the right decision. And I'm feeling that they are very clear on the fact that they can't waste your time anymore. If that's how you feel, that they have been wasting your time, or this is just not going anywhere, they are absolutely aware of this, and they will be making a decision. And I do feel that that decision is going to be wanting to be in your life, wanting to work towards this and to finally bring that mass down. Wow, I love this reading. Let me know what you thought in the comment box below. If you'd like to have a personal reading with me or order any of the oracle decks that I've created for you, all of the links are in the box below. I love you guys so much. Thank you for being here, and I'll see you all on the next video. All right, my beautiful group three who chose contentment. This is your reading. We're going to be looking at your person's true feelings for you at this time. And we're going to start here with your tarot. So let's take a look. Oh, we have the Sun. Beautiful. We have the Knight of Swords. And we have the Four of Cups. Wow, this is interesting energy. So right away, what I'm feeling is that your person is extremely enamored of you at this time, as in enamored in the best sort of way. There's something about you that they feel has brought a level of positivity into their life that they haven't been able to fully capture themselves. You know, like, I feel like your person, they tend to be a little bit pessimistic sometimes. I'm not saying like they're like a total like Debbie Downer or like a Danny Downer, but as in, I feel like they tend to sometimes get themselves into emotional ruts in life. This is something that's a bit of a pattern for them. And you know, that's natural, not a big deal. We all have that. That's part of the human journey, the human experience. I feel like it's quite common, as you know, life ebbs and flows and we go, you know, through different phases in life as we're growing, as we're expanding. Four of Cups is an energy that I feel is common. You know, we get to those places in life where we feel a little bit of, okay, I feel like I'm stuck in an emotional rut here, kind of don't know what to do, feeling a bit confused. There are options in front of me, but I really don't know which one to choose, right? And so sometimes we get into a place where, because we're not quite sure, we're not quite feeling it in any of the options that we have in front of us, we kind of just choose to sit there and look at them and not really budge, you know, not really do much. But you know, I like to think of the Four of Cups also as an energy of, you know, taking a break and not making a decision from a bad place, right? That if you can not feel pressured to make a decision in a particular moment, for especially when it comes to your romantic life, especially when it comes to matters of the heart, if you can kind of give yourself a break to weigh some of the issues that are going on, sometimes it actually works better than kind of rushing in and then doing things that you may regret. So see, look at your person. It's so interesting. They're coming through as the energy here of somebody who, Knight of Swords, it's like they may be the kind of person who does rush into things. They may be very communicative. Like when they first met you, they may have been super communicative. Like, right? Like you get a lot of message from them. You get a lot of contact from them. You feel like they, you know, they open open up so easily. Like, you know, they share their life story with you and you're able to share your life story with them. But I feel like there's something here about like the fact that they a bit regret the fact that they do this. They can come in quite fast. They can seem like they're very open, and they can seem like they're open to being vulnerable, opening their heart, sharing their secrets, like kind of just, you know, really being themselves in front of you. But then for some reason, the thing with the Knight of Swords is that as quickly as he or she can sometimes come in, they may also just as quickly kind of shut down. And so I feel like your person right now, in terms of their feelings for you, something like this may have happened where you may have been quite surprised that why is it that initially we had this amazing connection? We used to talk every day. Like, we probably exchanged like 100 messages per day and everything was going really good. And then maybe something happened or something didn't quite go right, and they may have stopped communicating in the same way that they were communicating before. And with this Four of Cups, I'm feeling that they certainly regret that they kind of went a bit into this I don't know what I want to do mode. I don't know if I really want this mode. So I feel like there's a lot of remorse and regret coming through here, because I feel like your person may have made this connection feel like a roller coaster for you without intending it, because I feel like their intentions are good, but they kind of get themselves wrapped up into these emotional ruts. So as quickly as they turn on or shut on, I feel like your person as quickly kind of shuts down or turns off. And I don't feel that it has to do with anything about you. I feel like this is a bit of a pattern that your person is used to being in. But at the same time, when it comes to you, it's like there's this beautiful, warm feeling of you bringing a deep sense of satisfaction, positivity, potentiality into your person's life that truly inspires them, that, you know, makes them want to believe in real love. Because I'm also feeling from your person, and, you know, take this as it resonates, you know, this may not resonate for everybody, but I'm also feeling for this person that they are very enthusiastic about falling in love. They're very, like, this is somebody who loves love. They want love. They want to fall in love. They love the process of falling in love. But I also feel that your person, once they have fallen and now they're getting into the real nitty gritty of a real relationship, that's when they start to falter. It's like they only know how to handle the fun part. Like, they only know, and they handle the fun part well, the part of having a great time, the part of talking for hours, the part of, you know, falling in love. But when it comes to managing a real relationship, this is where your person sometimes goes into this Four of Cups energies, and they struggle with the reality of it. So I'm not feeling that your person has any issues with communication. I feel like they're good at communicating. Their issue is that when things get real, when there are real consequences, when there's real feelings, when there is the possibility of a real commitment, that's when they sometimes emotionally shut down, because there's some level of fear, there's some level of blockages that come through for them. And then what they do is like, here, I have something amazing. I know that I'm falling in love, and, you know, I'm feeling this incredible energy, and you are just amazing. You're phenomenal. I love you, right? But then it's like there's something in them that gets triggered with the fear of, okay, will I be able to handle this? Will I be able to actually be in a real committed adult relationship? And that's where they start to falter. Okay, so I'm getting that the issue here is very much about them and not about you. Like, I feel like their feelings towards you are incredibly positive. So this is something that they're going to have to work out for themselves, because it's actually not fair. I feel like some of the behavior that this person engages in is not fair to you at all, because I feel like, and this is something they've done before, so it's not just towards you. I feel like they can come on very strong. They can come on so enthusiastic, like, I want this, I want this, I want you, you know, but then they come to like this screeching halt. They go like 90 miles an hour and then they come to a full stop. That's when they've hit their emotional kind of, you know, their emotional ceiling. And so this is something that your person is definitely going to have to work through, okay? If they truly want to be with you, if they truly want this relationship to be real, if they want it to last, if they want to show you how much they truly care and they want to actually be committed to you, I feel like this is where your person needs a new strategy. And it's so interesting that they're getting the strategy card, because I do feel that this strategy of what they have been kind of set into this particular pattern of, I love to rush into this. I love to fall in love. It's so exciting. I love to feel those romantic feelings and to explore that adventure. It's almost like they see love as an adventure. But when love becomes something real and not just the fantasy of that adventure, that's when the problems arise. So they really do need a new strategy of how they approach life, how they approach love, and how they approach their relationship with you. And I feel like this is something that is, for them, it's going to be so important. Look at this dragonfly emergence. Okay, so this is going to have to be a real metamorphosis for your person. And I think they very much realize that if they want to keep you in their life, if they want this, because I do feel that they feel that this love that they share with you is different. It's not the same kind of experience or relationship or love that they've had in the past with other people. There's something about you that is very different, very unique, and worth fighting for, like worth changing your way of operating, right? So this is why I feel like your person right now, their true feelings for you are so clear. Look at this new life. They want to do things differently. New life, new strategy, and an emergence into the next level. So this, I think, my dear ones, is so beautiful, right? This is such a beautiful energy, because this is about becoming conscious and aware that what they have been doing in the past is not going to work for them anymore. It's not working for them, and it's certainly not going to work for you, right? That they need to get to a point where they can follow through. I think their issue is definitely in the follow through, right? They can tend to make big promises, but then can they follow through on the promises that they've made, on them actually wanting to make this commitment? So we're getting the emergence card. And so I do feel that this is something that they do want to do. They want a new life with you. They want to emerge into a definitely new level, kind of like playing at a much higher level in love than what they have ever done in the past. And look at this. They also want to celebrate this connection with you. See, let go and have fun. So see, isn't it interesting how this is definitely the opposite of let go and have fun, right? Right? The Four of Cups is definitely the opposite energy of celebration and let's let go and let all our fears go and our blocks go and let's have fun. Let's let all the walls come down. This is definitely the opposing energy. So what I find really wonderful here is that your person is committed to shifting out of this into this mode of celebration, of, you know, letting go of, you know, all of that confusion or that emotional rut, and just saying, you know what, let's go with the flow. Let me truly invest in you. Let me truly invest in this relationship and open myself up in a way that I am not used to doing, because it's truly worth it. You know, it's truly worth it. I don't want to be like this anymore. I want to love, but I also want to love a real relationship. You know, it can't just end with the excitement and the initial honeymoon period, right? This is somebody who is now ready to emerge and transition into having a real life, not just that, you know, that kind of initial exciting honeymoon, but then it comes to an end. It never actually turns into real commitment. So what would they say to you? Yeah, look at these messages. Oh my gosh, they're so in alignment with their energy. Look at this. See, I contradict myself and give you mixed messages because I don't know what I want. See, this is the thing. So I do feel, right? And all this entire reading, isn't that amazing, guys? It's all been about them giving mixed messages, coming in strong and then shutting down. And then confusing you too, probably, right? Confusing you with their behavior. Like, what is it that they truly want here? Do they want this relationship or don't they? So I feel like for many of you, you may be in that frustration mode where you're kind of going back and forth and not knowing where you actually stand with this person. I want you to believe in me again. I know that I must take full responsibility for my actions. So again, I feel like this is them coming into that awareness, right? Emergence, strategy, changing their strategy when it comes to love, their life, everything they do, because I do feel that this is what is going to help them get to that next level with you especially. And then I feel that as they do that, it's going to improve their life all around. And that is always also an advantage for the relationship between the two of you. So this is good. You're gorgeous both inside and out. Being around you brings peace and light to my life. Wow, look at this. See? Oh my gosh. Isn't this amazing? This is this exact same energy of how they feel about you, the light that you bring. Look at the synchronicities here. So like this, I feel like these energies are exactly in alignment with the tarot cards. Look at this. I just want you to see how much in alignment this is right here. It's so amazing. This Four of Cups is exactly the energy of this message right here, right? The contradiction message. This Knight of Swords is the energy of this, right? Taking responsibility for your actions, you know, if you have been inconsistent, right? And wanting you to believe in them, right? And this is the same energy here. So it's amazing. I'm just so amazed. Thank you, Spirit, for the synchronicity here between the energies and the messages. They're exactly in alignment. Wow, beautiful. So let's take a look at the outcome. What does this person want to do next? Yeah, very good. Wow, wow, amazing. Oh, okay, so this person is really committed, okay? Really, really committed to healing the situation. Look at this. They're like, wow, there is like a deep commitment here. Look at this. To healing whatever has brought them to this point. Like, why are they behaving this way? Look at this. Healing, self-care, time out, be gentle with yourself and your twin or your soulmate, your love. I mean, this is beautiful. There's a lot of healing energy coming through here between the two of you. And release, see, loosen your hold, relax, unwind, release fear, anxiety, and doubt. So this is so beautiful. Look at how much energy we're getting flowing here about new beginnings, doing things differently, releasing all of the things in this Four of Cups that have been holding them back, holding back this connection. Whatever are the anxieties, whatever are the doubts, there is a new and fresh energy coming through here. They are raising their vibration. Look at this. This person is extremely committed, and I do feel that that commitment comes from the fact that you and their love for you is inspiring them to commit to this at a much bigger level. And like I said before, I feel very strongly that as you both are healing and as this person is releasing these energies and really being conscious about how they have behaved in the past and how they're doing things differently now, I feel that not only is your relationship going to be beautiful, from this point forward as you work on this. But I also, like, again, I feel very strongly that this is going to reverberate throughout your person's life. So the quality of their life is going to go up. And as a result, so is the quality of the life that you want to build together. So I love this. Let me know what you thought of this in the comment box below. If you'd like to have a personal reading with me or order any of the oracle decks that I've created for you, all of the links are in the box below. Thank you so much for being here, guys. You know how much I love you, and I'll see you all on the next video.